As everything is packed up and ready to go, it is time for us to head out from Bath. We have loved it here. This city has probably been one of our favorite destinations in our European travels so far. And that really says something because we've been to a lot of amazing places. But before we head out, we decided we wanted to just make a quick video to talk about the 5 most important aspects that you want to look at when choosing what self-catered apartment or house that you want to stay in with your family while traveling. Now, sometimes we'll stay in houses. We've also stayed in Airbnbs, but we love self-catered apartments and houses for a reason, especially this one that we've stayed at here in Bath. The Sacco apartments have been amazing. But we'll go into why it's important in just a moment. But the first thing you want to look at is the location when choosing where to stay. Location is so key because if you're way far out and you need a car to get around, that can get really expensive. Even if you have a car rental, gas here in Europe, it is a pretty penny. Here in places like Bath, where everything is so close together, you don't even need a car. We just took a bus from the airport and we've been going everywhere on foot. And so having a place to stay that is central to everything has been really great, especially at the end of the day when we're done exploring and we're exhausted and just want to go home. It doesn't hurt that we have like a killer view of the old historic Bath with the cathedral and everything out of our window. It's been really nice and gorgeous here. And so location is awesome. The next thing you want to look at with a self-catered apartment or home is the size. They come in all sizes, especially even in apartment buildings like this. The Sacco apartments, I think they have everything ranging from a 1-bedroom studio to a 2-bedroom. Since we have 3 kids with us, we opted for the 2-bedroom. This was the kids' room with the 2 kids' beds, the desk, and the TV, which was really nice because that way the kids were able to watch their shows at the end of the day when we got in and we were able to do our things. And have 2 bathrooms, which was nice because that way we didn't have to share a bathroom with our kids. I don't know about you, but that was a plus for me. Oh, I love that deep tub. Now, it's also nice, you want to have a large enough place because unlike the United States where things may be open late, here in Europe everything seems to close really early. As in, other than restaurants, if you're not eating out at night, everything closes by like 5 or 6. That means you're going to be spending a decent amount of time in your lodging. And where hotels can be nice, you're all crammed into a small little space together. And let me tell you, it is amazing to be able to come in at the end of the night and send the kids to one room, us to another. Sometimes we send them in here to the family room, which is big enough for all of us to relax, watch a movie and everything. Or put the kids in there and then we go into our own bedroom, which we have got. Now, the next thing that you want to look at is the amenities. The amenities is something that I always look at when I go. First amenity we look at is, do they have a Wi-Fi, a free Wi-Fi? Because honestly, not every place does. Sometimes they offer it, but often it charges. And so it's really nice to be able to have free Wi-Fi to be able to get online for us because we work from home. We also want to see if they have any upgraded Wi-Fi. And so like here at the Sacco Apartments, it's like £4 a day to get business Wi-Fi to be able to do some more intensive things on that. The other thing we want to look at with amenities is, what is their kitchen like? This is huge for me because groceries can get really, really, really expensive, or food when dealing with a large family. Here, let's kind of close that for a second there. When dealing with a large family, food is really expensive while traveling, especially if you're having to eat out all the time, which is one of the reasons why I love the self-catering apartments, because we can go and stock up on groceries and then have simple meals interspersed with eating out and enjoying the local food, especially breakfasts, because this way we can just have a relaxing morning, have breakfast in, and then head out for a day of exploring instead of having to drag ourselves out of bed first thing to get dressed to go. And so you want to make sure that your place has adequate like cups and plates and bowls and cooking materials and like pots and pans and everything, and definitely the cookingware, because that's not always the case. Another thing that you want to look at is, does your apartment have a washer and dryer? Anyone who travels with kids know kids get dirty, they get their clothes dirty. You want to be able to wash it and clean it along the way. Otherwise, you're going to be having to pack way too much. And that can add up in expenses other places. This ties in with the point of one of the reasons why we love self-catered apartments is the price. You know, you want to be able to have, be able to stay without spending a fortune, especially when traveling with kids. And so it's really great at the apartments because at hotels, to be able to get a hotel room large enough for your family, it can get really expensive. And at the self-catered apartments, they're often more reasonably priced. And it's fully furnished and it has the amenities, so it's literally like a home away from home. Even better is if they have any special offers or deals to lower the price, which this place had all of that. And lastly is, what kind of services do they offer? I love that this place has a 24-hour reception desk, so that if there's any emergencies, if anything's not working right, if I have any questions, like where's the grocery store and things, I can call them, I can ask them. And even with the apartment, they even have this nifty little book, which this is my favorite. It actually went through, and at the beginning, it had contact information. It had information for our safety and everything, fire safety, information about our apartment. Here's what comes with it. And this is my favorite part. It has instruction manuals for all the electronics. Now, anyone who's traveled a lot knows every stove is different, every washing machine and dryer is different, like how to work the water heaters are different, and trial and error can be really frustrating. And so being able to have the instructions where it walks you through exactly how to set everything, so you know right off the bat, here's how the dishwasher works, here's how the washing machine and dryer, it has been a lifesaver. So we love the Saco apartments for that. Now again, just to review the things you want to look at when looking at a self-catered apartment. Location, price, the size, the amenities, and the services. Those are the things that often they have that information on their websites, or if you call them up and ask them the questions, they can answer them. Those are the things that will determine which one you want to stay at. We can totally recommend Saco Apartments. They have been awesome for us. We've really enjoyed our stay here. It's been very much like a home away from home. But no matter where you're at, those are the things that you want to look at. And if you just follow those five simple steps, you will have an amazing stay wherever you go. Well, we will be back on soon with other fun adventures and a lot more pictures of our adventure here and back. So if you have any questions or comments or anything, just leave in the comment section and I'll be sure to respond. Bye.